Hi, hello, and welcome everyone to Site24x7's webinar series. This is Daniel. I'm the technical support engineer with Site24x7. And today we will go on the topic getting started with Site24x7 application performance monitoring, APM Insight. On today's agenda, we will get introduced to Site24x7 and we will check the different flavors of the web infrastructure monitoring and what is application performance monitoring and why it is important to have an application performance monitoring for your web applications and what Site24x7 has to offer for Site24x7 APM for Java, .NET and Ruby, how to set up, what are the features and functionalities, the real user monitoring and the APM Insight integration, how both of them are integrated, and then the mobile APM for iOS and Android native applications, and some of the best practices. So before we get into the topic, let me introduce to you who we are. Zoho Corp is the brand behind Site24x7. It started its business in 1996. And Zoho Corp has three major divisions. Zoho Work Online, which offers more than 30 plus software as a service products like business applications, productive and collaboration apps like CRM, creator, projects, and management division, which focuses on enterprise IT management products like help desk management, network management, active directory management, and many more. And Site24x7 would be a part of management division. And we have over 25 plus products under the Manage Engine division, which 90,000 plus enterprise companies use to monitor their infrastructure. And WebNMS, it's a framework solution model, which helps to build customized solutions. So we have major telecom service providers using our framework built by WebNMS. And that's pretty much about who we are and what we do. And Site24x7, what is it? Site24x7, it's a powerful all-in-one monitoring solution from the cloud. You can monitor your entire infrastructure from one single console. So we offer end-user monitoring, application performance monitoring, that's APM Insight monitoring, and then the server monitoring, the network monitoring, and then the public and private cloud monitoring. Under one single dashboard, you get the performance and availability data of your entire web infrastructure. So let's get into the web infrastructure monitoring. So we have some three major components when it comes to web infrastructure monitoring. One is the end user's perspective, the other one is the real user's perspective, and the third one, the developer's perspective. So here, the end user experience monitoring is done from a controlled environment where you can define the memory, the RAM, and the network through which the checks are done. And the real user monitoring, it's done from a real user, an actual user visit to your application. And the application performance monitoring, where it helps your developers analyze where the delay is. So using the end user experience monitoring and real user experience monitoring, we will get information on where the delay is, and you can work out on the delay using the application performance monitoring. So we will get a small introduction on the end user experience monitoring. So we have two flavors. One is the synthetic monitoring and the other one is the real user monitoring. The synthetic monitoring, as I said, it's done from a controlled environment, and real user monitoring, it's done from an actual user visit where you can measure the customer's emotion on performance and analytics. The end user experience monitoring, so Site24x7 has over 50 plus monitoring servers across the globe from where the end user's performance metrics can be monitored. And then the real user monitoring. So here you can monitor the actual user visit and what is the performance experienced by a user. And we provide data based on different metrics, such as the user's browser metrics, what type of browser a user uses to visit the web page, and what is the time taken to load. and then performance insight into various platforms, like whether it's a desktop, whether it's a Windows machine or a Linux machine, tablet or a mobile device like iOS or iPad or Android device. And you can monitor the individual web transaction, the page rendering time, the document processing, the front end and the back end time for an end user from the browser point of view. And then the segment performance by ISP. So we provide the performance metrics on different ISPs. So you can identify if there is an issue with a specific ISP when connecting to your website. Now let's get into application performance monitoring. So Site24x7's APM Insight is a developer's handy tool which gives you a visualization on the web transaction end to end. So the APM Insight gives unmatched visibility into the way web applications behave to the developers and the IT operations. So the IT operations, developers, and applications team can collaborate, and it enables to perform the first level troubleshooting in the application. And you get deep visibility into the application components from the URLs to the SQL queries. And you can also detect and diagnose complex application performance problems. We provide errors, traces, and exceptions with which you can diagnose application performance problems. So Site24x7 APM Insight, so we support Java, .NET, and Ruby on Rails applications. And recently, we have also integrated the APM Insight with real user monitoring, which we will discuss, and then the mobile application performance monitoring for native mobile applications. And then the architecture on how Site24x7 APM Insight works. So Site24x7 APM Insight, it's agent-based monitoring, where you need to install the agent in the app server. The data collection happens every 1 minute through a one-way HTTPS connection, and the collected data from the application server is sent to the Site24x7 server. And this will also make sure that the agent is always intact with the Site24x7 server. And then the data collected in the Site24x7, it's collated, and we provide you a dashboard where you can view the performance metrics of your application. And here you can identify the slow database queries throughput. You can measure the user satisfaction level using the AppDeck score and identify slow invocations in your code and keep track of individual method traces. So we will discuss them in detail now. So the APM Insight, it is supported for Java, it's Java 1.5 or above. For .NET applications, we need .NET Framework version 3. And IIS version 6 and above. For Ruby, it's 1.8.7 and above. And for Rails, it's 3 and above. And how to set up the monitoring? So it's simple. You need to download the agent from your Site24x7 account. So we have Java, .NET, and Ruby. And then using the license key, you need to install the agent. The agent will hook up with the application server, and then the performance metrics are pushed to Site24x7, where you have the application data. And Site24x7, it's a one-stop solution. So we have it for Java, .NET, and Ruby. So you can identify the slow invocations on your code and find the most executed database operations and its response time, the throughput. And you can find the most hit database tables. So for .NET, you can pinpoint the slow .NET application code and the busiest table and the most performed SQL operation on the table and map which web transaction is issued to the SQL call. And for Ruby on Rails, you can check for the database performance slowdown and the end user to database perspective monitoring. Some of the features with Site24x7's APM Insight, where you get deep visibility into your application. You get the application's response time, throughput, And you can monitor the end user satisfaction with the ABAC score we provide, the background transactions, errors, traces, the database operations, and you can also track custom application components. So this is the APM dashboard where we have multiple applications being monitored and the ABAC score, the average response time throughput, the errors, and the fatal error count. So I will take you to the product where we can see more information. So this is Site24x7's user interface for the application performance monitoring, APM Insight. And we have the list of applications being monitored. The ABAC score, which gives you the customer's emotions, whether the users are satisfied, tolerated, or frustrated. And then the average response time and the throughput based on the request per minute and error percentage and then the fatal error count. So this is the overview dashboard where we have the ABAC score and then the application component split up such as the network time, server time, the document download and processing time and the page rendering time. And here we have the average response time and throughput for your application and the ABAC score. And this is where we get integrated with the real user's perspective and the developer's perspective. So the browser's response time and the app server response time. The browser response time, we have it as network time, server time, page rendering, first byte, and the overall response time. And here the app server response time, we have the component splitups like HTTP connection, AWS S3, the HTTP client struts, and Memcached. And we have the top five slow transactions, and what are the response time, and the traces for the recent five slow transactions, and for exceptions, the recent five exceptions and its traces. So this is on the overview. And the web transaction, we give you the browser component split up and the app server component split up. This is the overall performance data. And then the exceptions, if there are any exceptions in the applications, we have that split up as well. And what are the exceptions is given here. And then the browser's transaction response time by component. So this is what we have in the overview page. And we have the data components split up for each and every web transaction. So for this DynamoDB.do, so we have this overview for each and every transaction. We have similar overview, so you can identify performance issues related to each and every transaction in your application. So the ABAC score, average response time, the throughput value, the app server transaction response time, and the app server component split up, and then the exceptions. And we can also monitor for the database calls, what is the time taken, the response time and throughput of the database operations, the database response time by operation, and the database operation by the caller. So if it's going to be a web service call, so that can be tracked here. And if there are any background transactions in your application, we monitor that as well. We provide you the component split up of it, the throughput. And here is the key feature with Site24x7 where we can get the traces of the application. So here we have set a threshold of 2 seconds. So if the response time is above 2 seconds, we will capture the traces. So here we have the trace details where we give in-depth analysis of the application's performance. So it helps your developer identify where the problem is and they can optimize the code for better end user experience. So here we have the slowest components in the application and the number of count and its response time, and how much it has affected the application performance. And if there are any external calls, we will have that performance report along with the type of request parameter, whether it's get method or post method. And then the JVM utilization, like the CPU utilization, the heap memory, and the non-heap memory. The garbage collector information on the total collections count and time spent, the collected objects. So with this out-of-the-box reports in the graphs, you can identify issues with your application and you can optimize it. And then thread information, the number of threads, the live threads, sleeping threads, and the CPU time and the user time for all the threads. And then the configuration information of the particular application. So what is the JVM version? So a complete insight into the configuration. So it gives the entire information on the JVM utilization and its configuration. And if there are any errors in the application, that would be captured as well along with its trace details. We will have the trace for the errors and exceptions, and the stack trace of where the error was occurred, and then the exceptions. And for each and every exception, we can get the trace as well. So the recent 5 traces of this specific exception can be tracked. And at last, we can have the integration of Site24x7's APM Insight with real user monitoring, where we get the response time by the internet service provider, response time by device, what is the performance on the Android, iPhone, Windows, Linux, and then the response time by browser. So this is pretty much about the application performance monitoring and its dashboard and the different components that we monitor using the APM Insight. These are the screenshots of what we have discussed in the product. And some of the key functionalities with Site24x7, where we support custom component, and then AWS component support is available. When an application accesses AWS services through AWS Software Development Kit, the APM Insight agent will automatically pick up those requests and starts tracking the performance of those service calls. So this will give you detailed visibility into split up of time taken by each of the component used in your application, which we saw in the product. And then it supports tracking log exceptions for the transaction. And for the .NET agent, it's a single MSI, it's single installer, where there's no separate agents for 32-bit or 62-bit. So the single agent, it automatically detects the version and sends the data to Site24x7. And we have the ability to view the transaction thread in a trace view. We discussed that in the product. And you can list the external components and its call count, the CPU time of web and non-web transactions, and you can capture the traces of transaction which exceeds the configured threshold, like the CPU or the number of calls to external services. And APM Insight for Java. So we are going to be specific on Java, .NET, and Ruby, what are the requirements. The compatibility, what are the application servers that are compatible, the components, the JVM and JDBC drivers that are required, supported, and configuration. So you need to specify the desired application name to display in the Site24x7 dashboard. And you can get the API key from the Site24x7 console. If there are any proxy settings, you can check. So These are the preliminary checks that needs to be done prior to configuring the APM Insight. And you can determine the APDEC threshold, because the threshold you define is what will be measured to calculate the user's tolerance, whether they are satisfied or frustrated. And you can enable the SQL queries and traces if required. So if you want them to be ignored, that can be done. And APM for .NET. So installation, you can run the installer and install it in the .NET agent. And you need to check the box when you try to start the agent after the installation. You can, during the installation, it will be prompted where you can check the box to start the agent. And you can check the license key. And after the successful installation, the applications running on the server will be monitored. And all .NET web applications hosted in the IIS will be monitored. It will be automatically discovered and added for monitoring. And the collected data from the agent will be seen in the Site24x7 dashboard within a few minutes. And for Ruby on Rails, the supported environment 1.8.7 and higher, and Rails it's 3.0 and higher. So you need to download and deploy the agent in your application server. And the agent installation can be done in two ways. You can install from RubyGems by using the command gem install site24x7_apm-insight. And you can also download the site24x7 apm-insight gem file from site24x7 account or from the RubyGems website. We have it available there, and you can use the command to install it. And the integration with real user monitoring. So monitoring from the real user's perspective and having those data collated with the backend experience. So integrating APM Insight with RUM captures and displays the application's performance, the click on the browser, the time taken for the response, and backend time in processing the transaction. So all in one view, which gives more value to have the monitoring done, both real user and the application performance monitoring. And integrated browser time and the server time, it helps you analyze the metrics together. So you can check for the time taken in the browser and the application server. And you can check for individual transactions performance from the browser as well as the application level. So the dashboard for the real user monitor integration, where we have a global performance analysis, and then the response time by internet service providers, the response time by device and by browser. And now getting into mobile APM. So nowadays we have a lot of mobile applications and a lot of websites and web applications are moved to mobile applications. People using mobile applications have increased in number nowadays. So Site24x7 has the application performance, native mobile application monitoring. So you can track the performance of your native mobile applications on actual end user devices. So from the end user perspective, you get the performance data. And the APM agent measures the execution time of your code using transactions and components. And the entire sequence of operations from launching the activity to rendering the final user interface will be considered as a transaction. So the entire sequence of operation. And individual operations can be grouped into different component types, such as the HTTP, SQLite, file system. And simple operations can be measured using just transaction, while complex operations can be measured using transactions with components. So here we have the mobile APM. So you need to inject the code that is provided in the Site24x7 console in your mobile applications code. So whenever the user installs the application, from the user's device, we capture the performance metrics. So by device and by OS version, what is the OS that the user is using? So if a user is using an older version of the operating system, then the performance impact, you can check how much impact a recent update that you have made is having with a user using an older version of the operating system or your application. And then the transaction level details for the mobile application, the response time, and the update score. Graphical performance by country. So we will, based on the network use, we get the information on the country. By the ISP, we get those information. So you get the performance across different country. And then by device type, as I said, whether it's a Samsung device, iOS, whatever device is being used, we get that information. And also the response time by the OS version, what operating system is being installed on the device, and what is the performance. And also based on the application version, where some users may use the older version, so you can get the app version performance metrics. And some of the best practices with APM Insight. So you can assign threshold for database traces and CPU. And you can use or help monitor the health diagnostic tool as the first step to troubleshoot the issues with .NET agent. And you can refer the agent logs for Java and Ruby on Rails. And you can monitor the managed exceptions, unmanaged exception will be monitored from the next release. And when it comes to pricing for the APM Insight, it is supported from the business pack. It's considered as an advanced monitor. So each and every application instance will be considered as one advanced monitor. So with business pack, you can have three instances monitored. So you can, for .NET, you can manage the instances using the app filters. And I hope the session was informative. So this is to introduce you to Site24x7's application performance monitoring, what it does and what are the different metrics and reports we offer. So if you have any questions, you can use the chat screen to ask me so I can answer them. So we have a question on the application discovery after installing the agent. A restart is required. The IIS server or the application server has to be restarted so that the agent will hook up with the application when the application starts. And also, the data is sent to the Site24x7 server in a 1 minute frequency. So every 1 minute, the data is pushed. And there has to be transactions performed in the application. It's only after that the agent will hook up with the application successfully. So if there are no transactions in the application, the agent will not hook up with your application. So after you install the agent, please do perform some transaction in the application to have the APM Insight agent hook up with the application and start collecting the data. And we have a question on alerting for the APM Insight. So currently, alerting is not supported, but we have it in our roadmap, which will be released shortly. We will have it included in our service. So I hope I have answered your questions. And if you have more questions, you can write an email to support@site247.com. And you can also view the presentation and video of this webinar in our webinars page, site247.com/webinar. So we are providing a series of webinars. For upcoming webinars, you can register, and you can also view the completed webinars there. I hope the session was informative, and you now have an insight of what Site24x7 and what APM Insight does. If you would like to have a one-on-one session to discuss in depth about the APM Insight monitoring, for example, you might be more focused on the .NET. So if you are interested to have a one-on-one session, please do write an email to support@site24x7.com. We will have a one-on-one session to discuss more about each and every component. Thank you everyone for your time during this session. You all have a great day.